Yeah, I think I've always liked to draw ever since I've been little. Every time I would pick up a pencil and I had a thought or something, like just seeing it, like I would spend like 2-3 hours sometimes on one piece. And then by the time you realize you're done or whatever, I remember being so hunched back over, like trying to straighten up was like, it hurt. But if I really feel into one piece, like I'll spend all day if I have to on it. I just get lost in it until I'm finished with it. Reality and responsibility, more than reality, but responsibility was, I guess, something hard for me to deal with. It's honestly, I didn't know what responsibility was, you know. And we had so much stuff, more than I would say the normal kid, I guess, because anything we pretty much wanted, I guess, in a way we got. Not to say we had everything, but I mean, we had enough, yes, you know. So, some things you just take for granted. But I never saw it that way. I just saw it as, well, you know, we had access to food in the fridge and you know, our own bed, our own room. You know, some kids don't even have their own room. But I guess I missed a lot of from, I would say, from like most of my 20s. I pretty much skipped it or missed out on it because I, you know, got involved in drugs and stuff. I was running from reality and responsibility. Now that I can look back on it, I didn't know what it was to be a man. I mean, I don't think you're necessarily born with a manual, and that when you hit, you know, 18 or 19, you figure, oh, I'm a man now, so I know this is what I have to do. Like I kind of just rode the boat at home, and I basically let my parents do everything. I never tried to prepare myself for that responsibility. Spending too much time on myself getting high, you know, I missed out on a lot of things. And I think a lot of that might come out. It probably is the reason why it comes out of my art now, because I think of, you know, I have a piece right now I'm working on called, I'm calling it The Double-Minded Man. And basically it's one person, but he's split into two different, you know, ways. But like the grace piece and everything, I mean, I always knew I was a good person inside. I guess I was always trying to be somebody else instead of trying to be who John Benjamin was. So being young as a person that, you know, I was, and then I grew into this different person, but it wasn't me. It wasn't the real person until I went through my ups and downs and tried to finally realize that it's just be yourself. Painters or sculptors use their gift and they're successful at it. I just feel like I tried so many other things and I never tried to do or make a living off of what God gave me as a talent. And I'm never proclaiming to be the greatest artist, because I'm not, but I think I'm pretty good at what I do, and especially if it comes from a place that is on high and God is leading me in this direction. I give Him all the glory for it. It's about time that I use what He's given me so freely to be successful. If I finally do what He's asked me to do, that my life will not go wrong, because it's not really my life, it's His life that He's given to me. Those how awesome and powerful God can be. You know, I don't deserve any kind of blessing or any kind of second, fifth, 12th chance. But obviously He does. He feels it's a better that I'm better than what I think I am. He knows the difference. So I just want to give back now what he's given me.